I am going to have somebody special join me in a second. So I'm just waiting for her to log on and then I will invite her in. And there she is. Okay. I'm super excited. So, you should.
Yay! Hi! I'm good. Let me turn you up. Sorry. How's that?
Very good. I'm super excited to have Sandra Veum, who is my friend and fashionista. So, Sandra, tell me a little bit about what you do.
Well, I have had my business now 15 years, and gosh, I'm a personal wardrobe stylist, so I help everyone basically be the best version of themselves. I like to say I like to help build in confidence through your wardrobe, be more of a strategic shopper, so I shop for people, now a lot online. I do closets and edits and help get it in place and then create items, you know, a strategic list of what you may be missing. When people start traveling again, I pack for people. So I style their trip, whether it's business or pleasure, and then I actually pack for them. And so they just have pictures when they travel, you know, wherever.
That's the coolest thing. Oh my gosh. I hate packing for trips.
Most people do. So I have a lot of clients that actually, it's funny, more women than men for that, for whatever reason.
But we tend to overpack. We take everything.
We do. And the good news is I always give you one extra. So like I give you that, you know, just in case I wake up in a different mood. But it's all about being interchangeable. So yeah, between closets, editing, I have shopping tours in the city when we get back to our new normal. And I give, you know, presentations, style presentations, and I work with companies on dress codes.
Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah.
Tell me more about that.
That has evolved quite a bit. So especially with the whole transition of a lot of companies, especially in California, changing to a little bit more of a, when I say casual, a professional casual environment.
Right.
I think we're gonna see more and more of this, especially after quarantine, that more companies will do this. But there's a discrepancy because a lot of people don't know what that looks like to still look professional, still be comfortable, presentable, represent the company and yourself, your own personal brand, correctly and not look sloppy, you know?
Oh boy. I'm never a fan of like casual Friday. I always feel that people get very lax in their attitude and their work ethic when they're too casual.
They don't know. So that's the thing. It's all about teaching them what that looks like. Cause I supply visuals. I talk about your own personal brand cause that's just as important as your company brand. And there's a lot that goes into it, but I try to make it as fairly simple as possible and have fun doing it. I am all about having fun.
Well, I've had the opportunity to have you come and help me shop in my closet.
Yes.
Can you kind of go over how you do that? So everybody, and how you would do it right now virtually.
Well, so I've been actually virtual for a while because a lot of my clients, that's okay. They can bark any day. I wish I had one right now to bark. I've had my business virtual already because a lot of my clients, not a lot, but some have moved away. And so they wanted to continue working with me. And then they also referred me to some of their friends that live in other states.
Okay.
So virtually, I've always done closets through like Marco Polo, FaceTime. But now with Zoom has really enlightened a lot of opportunity, especially with businesses. I've been doing a lot of style presentations, happy hours for, you know, groups and companies.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah. Yeah. So virtually, so your question was how did we work together? And then we'll talk about how you did it virtually. But so basically I have put together a questionnaire that's sort of a screenshot for myself to kind of see where someone's at and where I'd like to take them. And obviously we have a complimentary consultation over the phone. And I really try to tailor it as much as possible to that person and their needs because everyone's different. I always say it's like perfume, you know, you spray it on and it smells different on everyone's, you know, chemical composition. So there's a lot that goes into it, whether it's, you know, they don't have a style. We need to, you know, help create that. Or, you know, they're bored with their wardrobe. They feel they have nothing to wear. So in your case, you're a fashionista automatically. I mean, look at you. You're, you know, phenomenal. And
I'm wearing one of my kimonos.
You're wearing Valerie's, right? Love a lot. Yeah. Gorgeous. Jennifer Grace, I believe, right? The designer, mm-hmm. local designer. Fabulous.
Yep.
And one of my favorite boutiques. And I've been wearing a lot of those, by the way, because they're so cool. But I will tell you, today was my first try on my jean moment. I was really scared this morning because Ooh. I have not tried on my jeans. Even though I've told everyone, try your jeans on. I buttoned them. I'm so excited.
Yay!
Yeah, they have stretch in them. So that's still, that's so oh I actually gosh. Have something structured. But, and I'm representing, you know, the shoulder treatments, which is on trend for summer. Ooh. But anyway, and this is Le Village, which is part of Chateau Village. I think you own this, don't you?
I don't own that one. That's super cool, though.
That would look great with what even you have on.
Yeah, I don't have a necklace on today.
That's okay, because you got the print and you have statement earrings, so it's all about balance. So you're okay. spot on. Okay. So in your case, you're a natural fashionista. So, you know, your language is my language, meaning we have a lot of clothes. And that's okay. I mean, like I say, that's my language. But it was more about, I know that you had some questions on pieces of, does it still represent you? So when we did our most recent style appointment together, it was about trying things on, making sure that we still love it, and that it still represents you. Yeah, yeah. And your current lifestyle, because you've even said you're trying to get more of that, oh, hello.
Oh, sorry. She's supposed to not be barking.
Well, she's a star. I mean, come on.
I know. She
Talk about
a
the best accessory.
Right now. Look at this mess.
Oh my God, though. She's
I'll
so
just
cute.
Put her over here on the kitchen.
No, that's fine.
Sorry.
So
about
basically,
that,
with you, we talked about how you can still be chic, but kind of that effortless chic where you were kind of wanting some more upgraded. Casual professional clothing. Remember you had talked about, like, what does that look like? Because you've got that glam look natural. And
thank you. And
I don't even think you have the issue of ever being too casual. But it's more about, in your case, elevating even more so, like how to tailor maybe something down but still look like, you know, yourself. And then we got rid of some things, you know, that just didn't speak to your life anymore, didn't make you happy. And I helped put together and maybe enlighten some other, you know, prints together and textiles and mixing patterns and color combinations. And that's where the pictures came in. Very similar to what you do. And I know we're going to have another Instagram live of how you have helped me in buying and selling homes. So it's very, very similar with that. You know, you enlighten, having someone look through other eyes sometimes help enlighten something that even you do for a living, you know. So, you know, I really appreciate what you've done for us as well.
Oh, thank you. I love you guys. How long have we known each other? Was Lauren born?
No, I was pregnant. So
That's
she's going
God.
To be 21. Yeah. So
amazing.
2 years. I know. And we have, as we talked about, you have sold our house, our first house, and then we purchased our home through you. So phenomenal. Yeah.
21. Gosh, it had to be then 21 plus years.
Oh yeah. 22 years. So we've been in this house 21 years. Yeah.
That's
so
crazy.
Thank you all to you.
Thanks. So, you know, for me, what I love about you, so many things I love about you, but the fact that, you know, so many people get stuck using like how much of their clothing, what percentage
would
you
say? 20%, 80, but yeah.
And then we just keep buying stuff that we don't use or don't need. And you're so good at just coming in and being like super frank. Okay, love it or leave it. Like, what's your deal? And it's funny because there's that one funky dress that I have in my closet right now.
Well, yeah.
The other thing that's kind of hard is you put together a bunch of cool outfits for me and this happened, you know, like it wasn't
that long
ago.
But I'm warning people, we will be getting back out.
Exactly.
And there will be that new normal. So I don't want people to just think this will be our life forever, even though it feels like it. We will get back to a new normal. And that's where do not become, not you, I'm not speaking to, but like lazy, have a quarantine mind when we do get back out.
Oh, so true. I'm really worried about that, actually.
Yeah.
So multiple thoughts in my head. One of them is, so helping businesses, are you doing a lot of helping people with their Zoom appearance?
So what, you know, I create the topic once I talk to them. So it really depends. So the business one that I did, a company, they were wanting at like a happy hour, sort of different topics. And so I was one of the style segments, and it was for men and women. And so really at that point, because it was early on, it was the end of March, we were talking a lot about the Zoom style and, you know, how to still look presentable or not wear a strapless, you know, and you look like you're naked. I mean, a lot of people don't. And lighting, you know, lighting's a big thing. But we also talked about when you do get back into the workplace, what that is going to look like, and items about how to still be comfortable. And being comfortable is still about fit. It's more about the material. You know, you don't have to dress big and lose your silhouette to be comfortable. Right. So we all are going to get out of our sweatpants and have to try on our jeans and have
well,
to
I'm
wear
super
dresses.
Stoked your jeans are doing well. Right?
Woo-hoo.
Awesome.
Yep. You know, look, I can still have my leg in it.
I love it. It's, you know, I'm trying every single day. You know, I've got a super strict routine that I'm doing. You know, wake mm-hmm. up at either 5 a.m. or 5:45, depending on
wow.
if I have to wash my hair. And
I know, today
was the day I washed my hair. I had rollers in, and I rode my bike in the garage on its trainer. It was hilarious.
Oh, my God.
With my
it.
Rollers in. but I just feel like, you know, to be able to get dressed normally, right?
Doesn't it change your psyche? Okay, so
yesterday,
oh my gosh. So this is how desperate in a sense I am. So I had an essential doctor's visit. I actually was excited. I washed my hair. I did it. I wore a cute little, you know, it was a sweat outfit, but a cute, you know, like a cute ensemble, cute
yep.
jacket. And they were like, oh, look how cute. You know, it was just funny because I'm like, oh, I can at least it's the girls checking me in at the doctor's office. But I felt so much better about myself all day.
Yesterday, we had a listing appointment. So we have to put on gloves, right?
Yeah.
Our mask that I had
yep.
Jasmine made from Bellage.
I have one too from there, a dragon
yes.
one.
Yep. In fact, I'm ordering more. I'm going to get a denim one. So when I have my
oh,
denim
yeah.
jacket on, I have a cute denim
so cute.
Mask, right?
And think
so
of contrast too. Like if you have
yeah.
a color, that denim will look really cool.
So I put on heels
yeah.
and my booties. I had to literally put blue surgical booties over my heels, but I didn't care. I was like, yes, I'm dressed up. I'm
yeah.
a very good dress. But
yes.
even at Zoom meetings, because we do a Zoom every single day, 6 days a week.
I love what you're doing.
Like
and
our company
cooking
is like
so cool.
on fire with keeping yep. us ahead of the curve. But I'm always like, what do I wear today? Like I want to wear something. I just put it on and wear it.
Well, and that's what's important. I'm really glad that you said that, because what I'm telling people is, even if you do game night Zoom, you know, or house party or a Zoom dinner with friends or a cocktail hour, get dressed, get used to that. Because again, we will be out and with or without a mask. I mean, obviously a mask right now, but you know, it does change. It is a proven fact. You feel better about yourself. And I do feel it affects your work, whatever industry you're in.
Yeah.
Or dating life or anything.
I have friends of mine, Ellen and her daughter, Sarah, who mm-hmm. I will introduce you to as we move forward. And they do the coolest thing on Friday. They get dressed up in like gowns.
Oh,
and
wow.
tuxedo. Yeah,
oh.
I mean, they get dressed up. So that Sarah has two little kids, and Aviva decided right at the beginning of our stay at home,
yeah.
I want Friday to be like Fashion Friday. And
love
so,
that.
You know, they get dressed up. They wear like
yeah.
special little outfits. The grandpa, David, wears a tuxedo often.
Oh.
They make fun, really cool dinners, and they do FaceTime together because they live, both of them, Bankers Hill and Mission Hills, but yet they haven't seen each other in months.
Correct.
So I
yeah.
love that they're doing that. It's very fun and creative.
That's what I tell people. Just start really putting, you know, you need to work your brain still. And this is a good time to visit your closet if you
That's
haven't.
That's why I was thinking for you.
Yeah, so it definitely is a good time. But I also tell people when I'm talking with clients right now, they're like, I want to get rid of everything. And I'm just going to be casual. I don't need anything. And I'm like, okay, hold on. First of all, no one really needs clothing for the most part. I mean, we all have enough clothing, whether you have a lot or you don't, we all have clothing, right? That'll cover us. But there is, again, that psyche where you do want to buy strategically. I do think people will at first buy a little bit less. So I want to help them be more strategic with their buys. Now's a really good time to go online and get some, if you think ahead for winter, and some really cool jackets, because now they're so affordable. So for instance, I just found, I love Kobe Halperin. I don't know if you know the brand Kobe Halperin. Oh, awesome, awesome clothing designer. And this jacket, it's a gorgeous light velvet quilted with embellishments on it. It sounds crazy, but it's not. It's going to look so gorgeous with a black slip dress and a booty going out, you know, come winter.
Cool.
Now, that was, and I kept the price tag on, $685. I got it for $85.50. I kid
Whoa.
You not. So now I'm telling people, think ahead. So right now, make a list of what you feel that you may be missing, or let's work together and I will help you compile that list. And then we do that online shopping for you now. You know, so then you're prepared going forward. And I understand, you know, people right now, the world is unknown right now, whether it's jobs, the industry. And so I want to be respectful with that as well. And so it's all about, some people, it's more of in a budget conscious, you know, situation, could totally still work with that.
Yeah.
And they're just chomping at the bit to get out there and buy something new, you know, so there's a range, and I work with all and I enjoy all of it.
So let's say, for example, I see Kathleen Cottrell is on from, I don't even know where you are right now, Kathleen. Are you in Texas? Her husband, Ted, used to be the defensive coordinator for the San Diego Chargers and
okay.
my Buffalo Bills.
Woohoo!
So, yeah, and she lived in Santa Luz and we became really good friends. And she's a redhead. So let's say, for example, Kathleen, who doesn't live in San Diego, wants to have you review her closet. How do you do that on your virtual?
So after having, the big thing will be that complimentary consultation and really piece out, I'll ask key questions so that it'll help me sort of fine tune where to start. And so then I'll develop a plan of maybe give them some things to work to do, like pulling items that they're having trouble in their closet already and not knowing what to do, sort of as a good point to start on something virtually. And then literally we would just go through closets and, you know, start with those pieces that are having issues with. There may be some questions on fit. So we'll have to, I'll have, you know, they'll step aside, try it on, come back. So between FaceTime, Zoom now, and an app called Marco Polo, which is basically I love it. It's where you can talk to someone at any point, like you could be sleeping and at midnight, I'm still up and I'm curious about this top. And so I'll film myself and send it to you. I wake up, I'm able to see it, but it keeps a log, a chronological log of the pictures and any sort of video. So I can refer back to things on clients and then go, okay, remember this top that you had sent me 2 months ago, let's put that now with that color jean now that it's summer, or, you know, so yeah, it's a great app.
Marco Polo?
Marco Polo, yeah.
Okay.
And I had one of my clients that doesn't live here, she's the one that informed me about it a few years back. So we've been using that. I've already used it. So there's so many different ways. And then what happens is once I see what they possibly are missing and really get to know their lifestyle, because you need to match everyone and what their true need is. And then, you know, do the online shopping. Right now, as stores are opening up, I can do online to where I can check market of what's in their store, wherever they're located. And then they can drive up to pick up now.
Nice.
Or, and that's happening here as well. So I just did that for Gucci. Put in a call. It's very simple. They sent a link My client was able to purchase it and then just drive up. There's a spot at one of the valets. They assign a spot to. They walk it out to with gloves and masks, all beautifully packaged. Done. So birthday presents, you can still, because I help people shop as well, you know, so birthday, graduation gifts.
Oh, gosh, yeah.
So you can really fine tune it with online, you know, so they could either do a pickup at the store, meaning outside of the store. A lot of the boutiques are also, they've been doing this to where you can drive by. I know Valerie's been really good about that.
I ran down and got one of these, this one actually from her.
And do you have one of her silk wrap dresses?
No,
it has a Levelage tag in it. So it's one of their own brand. I will show them after this. It is stunning. And it, I love them because you can wear them as a dress, a wrap dress. And sometimes wrap dresses don't cover if you have the girls, you know, and this has enough material to cover, which is what I really love about it. And then, but you can also tie it just like a kimono. So you kind of get a twofer out of a deal. Actually, you could get a threefer. I could tie it behind now that I think about it and do it like a kimono. Yeah. So I have it in a lot of my style presentations. I own three of them because they're super colorful. You would love it. And it's a washable silk.
Ooh, thanks for that tip.
Yeah.
So you were talking earlier about your top that you're wearing. Tell us kind of some of the things that we should be looking for. And about your website and your newsletter and how you always analyze fashion ahead of time so that we know what's going on?
Yeah, so I put together always I put it in two different seasons because, you know, for the most part, I'm thinking San Diego, but it attributes to anyone living anywhere. But I like to keep things as simple as possible. I feel like if you give too much information, you know, it kind of goes in one ear and out the other. So I put together a spring summer trend report and a fall winter trend report. And I always do it ahead of the time. And I always tell people, think of a trend, not something that you have to buy to be in style. What a trend means is that this is what you're going to be seeing in stores or online more and more. This is what you'll see in inventory. Doesn't necessarily mean, like right now, it's all about high neck and voluminous sleeves and shoulder treatments. Well, if you have
shoulder pads, oh my word.
Well, just even, you know, the poofy, you know, the ragamuffin sleeve, the poofy sleeve, or, you know, it's very exaggerated. Now I have broad shoulders and so I have to be careful with that, but I still kind of like a lot of that. So if you can see with this, you can still wear them, but it's all about the material and if it drapes nicely. Something that would be sticking out on me, it may read a little bit too, it's wearing me versus I'm wearing it. So this, I liked how it draped. It still gave accent at my shoulder. The print, I like to be a little bit graphic. And so it's not as overwhelming, but I don't mind it, you know. I don't mind more is more as long as it's done correctly. So, you know, I picked up the lighter color with the red and just threw it on with a jean. And then I've been wearing a lot of my slides, mules. These are Lucky Brand. You can find them on sale right now. They're great. And this is a muted gold, so it goes with so much.
Ooh, I need to grab
and
some
I can
of
wear
those
that.
The house.
Oh, totally. They're almost like cute house slippers, but I wear them out as well. So,
those are
even
awesome.
With your
I've been trying to find cool things to wear inside the house because I don't wear shoes in the house. So, yeah.
You would love these. I have a million of them. And like I said, they're all over the place. And you can catch sales right now as well.
And it's Lucky Brand?
Well, Lucky Brand is, you know, Lucky the store.
Yeah.
That's what that brand is. And I think I have three from them, different materials and styles. Yeah, they're actually on sale for sure right now.
Oh, I'm going to look. So Kathleen just asked a question. She has a varied lifestyle where she travels a lot, but then she's home a lot. How do you help somebody that has that type of lifestyle?
Well, so I would ask her a little bit more questions of what it looks like when she stays home, what her life is, and then what she did for a living, because I'm all about utilizing your wardrobe as much as possible and not segregating, like, this is my work closet and wardrobe. This is my going out. This is my casual. I like to sort of combine those because I like mixing casual with, dressy, and I like being able to mix a blazer you might wear for work with your denim. You know, so I try to get the most out of your wardrobe and really combine them, because it's all about layering. So there's an art to layering and having those pieces that layer correctly. So to answer your question without really knowing specifics, you know, I would really try to find, it's about the material. You know, to me, when I hear travel, I want it to be easy. I want it to not wrinkle. I want it to be interchangeable. So it's about, you know, packing with a certain color palette, so they're easily interchangeable.
Oh, I like the color palette packing.
Yeah. I mean, that's really important. And then having less foundation pieces, meaning your bottom pieces, having more to interchange out on top, because, you know, you don't, again, you're trying to underpack. And shoes, you know, you really want to be strategic with your shoes, which I know is hard for a lot of us, including you.
That is the hardest part. It's the shoe.
I know.
I swear to God, like, I know some people who can get on an airplane with a roll-on bag.
I know.
To go to Europe for 3 weeks. I'm like, are you
kidding
me?
That would not be me. But I will tell you, I packed for someone. So I have a client and she was in Europe for 3 months, almost 3 months.
Wow.
And different destinations. So I had one, that wasn't carry-on, but it was one suitcase. And I packed everything, even hats. There's a whole strategy of how to pack hats.
No way.
And have to correctly to where you're not losing space. So that's a little secret, if you ever hire me, that, well, you and I will talk, but, you know,
I love
help
that.
People. But I was able to pack for her for the almost 3 months in Europe, different destinations. Yeah.
That is super cool. And talk a little bit. In fact, Kathleen says, I'm cleaning out my shoe closet.
Oh, well, if you ever want to send me pictures before you get rid of something, it's funny. A lot of times people get rid of things that I, now if they're in bad shape and you can't fix them and they're still in style and they're still comfortable, then yes, you know, I mean, if they're not comfortable, it's time to go. But sometimes people get rid of things that I'm like, no, don't get rid of that, because one, these are really hard to come by and maybe it just needs some tender loving care. You know, taking it to a shoe repair person, getting new soles put on. But is it comfortable? I am, my life no longer is about killing my feet. I am done with that. You know, so I will try to sell those and I help people. I let them know, like, okay, let's try to sell these, you know, whether it's when the consignment stores reopen or the Real who are doing home pickups, or, you know, just donating, you know, getting a tax write off if needed. So
and that is a big piece of what you do. I love that you help people with, you know, it's once you make those piles of stuff that you're editing out, you know, you want to be able to give to a charity. You want to be able to possibly, you know, consign stuff, and you take care of all of that for your clients.
Oh, right. I one-stop shop. I leave with the clothing because I also don't want, sometimes people have a tendency to go back in the bag and pull things out that shouldn't be out.
I've done that a couple times when I said, oh, I'm taking these to work to, you know, give to help people at the office. And every now and again, I'm like, oh, but I'll take that out. Nobody will know that I snuck it back in. You've even come to my closet a couple different times and like you've seen, okay, you've still got that. And that one dress that is hanging up there, I still need to do something about that. That's just not me.
Well, you know, the thing is that I tell people is that there's always a time when you're finally ready. And so I will let people know for those, sometimes it's an emotional attachment or for whatever, you spend a lot of money. There's always a reason. Put those aside and really kind of move on and do whatever you're doing and don't put as much thought. Keep editing your closet. But then go back to that. And does it really do anything for you? Is that going to be the dress that you're going to go to when you have an event? And if it isn't, it's time to let it go. It's time to be free. And then either sell it or donate it, whatever the case is, and then get something that truly brings you joy and that fits you now, meaning what you love. Like these caftans, you know, that it's so you and you wear it so well. And the kimonos, you know, you could get so many. I always like to look for items that you can get different looks with. So like what you have on, oh my gosh, you can tie it a million different ways. You can wear it with jeans, you know. So again, I'm about stretching that dollar. no matter how big someone's budget is, and try to create those different looks. I mean, I just love that because I feel sorry, and you know this, I know this sounds weird, but I feel sorry for purses or shoes or clothing that someone buys and then they don't wear them and it just sits in their closet. I call that museum shopping. And
oh.
And I feel sorry for the clothes. They want to go out and have a walk, right?
Right? Especially during these times.
Well, right. So,
tell me a little bit about what the three of you are doing. Is Chris working? Is he working from home?
Oh, yeah. And he goes into the office a couple, 2 to 3 times a week. And they're up and running. It's essential business. So they're designing and they're actually busy. Yeah. So they're doing great. Doing a lot of virtual. They've created sort of fun environments to kind of keep people, you know, still having fun with work. And so like taking pictures of who has the best, you know, workstation or, you know, sort of what they're taking a picture while you're out for your walk, you know, and whether it's funny or something inspirational or beautiful, like flowers or something.
I love that.
Yeah,
that's
so just to
very
kind of
cool.
Keep it going. And then Lauren, our daughter, she's online with school. She's in her third year at Cal Poly, San Luis Obispo. So she's doing a fantastic job, rocking it, killing it, doing great.
Is she
just
okay?
The business marketing.
You know, I know a lot of college students are feeling really bummed out that they're not with their
Course she's bummed. Yes. I mean, they're definitely bummed, but she's making the best of it. And at some point, you know, she will go back up. And we're going to allow that, you know, at some point you have to, she knows how to live the current situation and not take chances and be a responsible young adult. And
so well, that's good. That's super
great.
Good to hear. Yeah. Cause it does. It makes me sad to hear, you know, some of my friends that have college kids and our seniors, our high school seniors and our eighth graders that are, you know, not able to have the experience that they want to have.
It is sad, and I'm glad to see some of the schools, you know, at least showcasing them, doing some special things, but it's not the same, and it is unfortunate. But what I tell some of my clients who have kids at that age is that, you know, as tough as that is, and it's easy for me to say that, now's the time that's really going to hone in on you as a person and create maybe skills that you weren't even, that you knew about that was in you, or your tenacity or your creativity. Like these are moments where it sort of sometimes you can really champion, even though it is a negative impact, you can champion that and make something from it for yourself, because you'll become that much better of a person as you grow older.
That's so true. That is so true.
I like to think anyways.
Hey, Philip.
Oh, hi, Philip.
He's somewhere. Mackenzie sees a gecko out the window and she's about to
I hear her.
A little lizard. She lives for them. It's hilarious.
Oh my God, I love it.
The other day I was going out in the garage to get my bike shoes on, to get on my bike. There was a gecko in my bike shoe.
Dead?
No, he was thing, just peeked his little head out and looked at me. So of course now, every single morning, I like shake my shoe to make sure there's nothing in it. And I was able to get him out of the garage, which was my goal.
Well, I'd rather have a gecko than a scorpion, because I'm from Arizona, so geckos are better than scorpions.
That's true. Well, I really appreciate you coming on. I miss you so much.
I love all that
you're doing. And
likewise.
Your website, tell them the name, Mariposa
Style. So www.mymariposastyle.com. And I'm also on Instagram, just my handle is Sandra Veum. I also do Pinterest. And by the way, Pinterest is another great way to help speak to virtual clients, because I create boards, inspirational style boards for people. So I'm on Pinterest, my name, Sandra Veum. I also have, I'm on Facebook, so I have a personal one, but then I have Sandra Veum for Mariposa Style. I'm on Twitter, but I'll be honest with you, I don't tweet a lot. I have to be honest. It's attached to whatever I post on Instagram. So I always say pick a lane. I only have so much time for, you know, I'm trying to stay relevant with what I could still do. So at least it's connected. So
yep.
Twitter, but not really. So more Instagram. Okay.
I don't do it. I picked a lane a few years ago, yeah. And my lane is Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn. That's it.
Oh, LinkedIn too, I'm on. Yes, and that I agree. So, yes, because everyone, there's a different audience for all of those.
Correct.
So, and, you know, it's basically my name, Sandra Veum, that's V-E-U-M, and I would love to help anyone virtually here when we open back up. I know you and I will get together the minute we open back up.
Absolutely. Can't wait. I know I've been struggling with that casual, you know, the casual bottom look.
Yes. Know, like, well, and that's one of the biggest questions. It's always the bottom look. And so I tell people like jogger style, track pant, those are still super comfortable. And then, you know, you could still pair it with a cute t-shirt, you know, drapey sort of boyfriend style t-shirt or an open weave jacket. So you're still putting an outfit together. I mean, I'm super comfortable in these because these jeans have spandex and they're a good rise. So I feel lock and loaded when I'm sitting, yep. You know, or standing. And it's all about the raw edge. So you want to find someone that has like kind of a fun raw
edge. Yeah.
Or the capri fit and flare style. That's really big this season as well. And again, this is super comfortable. It's airy. As to me, at my age, as long as I can breathe and feel, you know, airy and lightweight, that's what I'm all about.
I love it. I love it. Well, I appreciate it. Thank you so
much. Oh my gosh, thank you. I really appreciate it.
Yes.
Thank you.
Exactly. This was so fun. I feel like we at least got to hang out together a little bit.
I know.
You know, my thing is stay physically distant while staying socially connected. And this is just such a great format to do that. Just making sure everybody out there is doing okay during these wild times.
You have been brilliant at that. And I want to thank all of your viewers. So thank you so much. And I have to give a shout out to your pop of color tea kettle in the back. Love that.
Oh, that's so funny.
Thank you know me and my papa color.
Yeah, I love it. All right, sweetie.
All right.
Take care.
Take care. Bye, everyone. Stay safe.
Bye.
Bye. Happy styling.